morning students. In structure of atom today, we are going to study the Rutherford's atomic model and its drawings. Ernest Rutherford gave a model of an atom, that is the structure of an atom, on the basis of alpha particle scattering experiment. Ernest Rutherford performed the alpha particle scattering experiment in 1911. And from this experiment, he drew some conclusions. The conclusions are, number one, the conclusions of alpha particle scattering experiment. First conclusion is, most of the space in an atom is empty. Most of the space in an atom is empty. Second, an atom contains small, massive positively charged nucleus. So the conclusions of alpha particle scattering experiment are, most of the space is in an atom is empty, and an atom contains small, massive, positively charged nucleus. So these are the conclusions of alpha particle scattering experiment, which was performed by Ernest Rutherford. Already we have studied that experiment. In the alpha particle scattering experiment, we have seen that most of the alpha particles passes through the gold foil. They penetrate the gold foil, while only few alpha particles bounce back from the gold foil. So this was the alpha particle scattering experiment, and from that experiment he draw the conclusions. Number one, most of the space in an atom is empty, and the other is, an atom contains small, massive, positively charged nucleus. These are the conclusions which are drawn from the alpha particle scattering experiment. And on the basis of these conclusions, Rutherford proposed the model of an atom, that is the structure of an atom. He suggested the structure for an atom. The atom is very small actually. The size of atom is about 10 raised to power minus 10 meter. And the size of nucleus is further smaller. It is about 10 raised to power minus 15 meter. Size of atom 10 raised to power minus 10 meter. Size of nucleus 10 raised to power minus 15 meter. Now, here the Rutherford's atomic model, which was given from the alpha particle scattering experiment, had some features. Features of Rutherford's atomic model. Number one, an atom consists of tiny means small, positively charged nucleus. An atom consists of small, that is tiny, positively charged nucleus. A nucleus contains positively charged particles that is the protons. A nucleus contains positively charged particles, that is the protons. Almost complete mass of an atom is concentrated or accumulated or collected in the nucleus. This was the first feature of Rutherford's atomic model. According to the Rutherford atomic model, an atom consists of tiny positively charged nucleus. A nucleus contains positively charged particle, that is the protons, and almost complete mass of the atom is concentrated in the nucleus. Means almost complete mass of the atom is accumulated or collected inside the nucleus. Then second feature of Rutherford's atomic model the electrons equal in number to the number of protons in the nucleus. The electrons equal in number to the number of protons in the nucleus are revolving around the nucleus. Electrons are revolving around the nucleus in circular orbits. The electrons equal in number to the number of protons in the nucleus are revolving around the nucleus in the circular orbits. Here the number of electrons are equal to the number of protons present in the nucleus, and the electrons are revolving around the nucleus. Means an atom resembles the solar system. An atom is just like a solar system. In the solar system, the planets are revolving around the sun. Just like that solar system, in an atom, the electrons are revolving around the nucleus. In the atom, electrons are revolving around the nucleus, and therefore there is a similarity between the atom and the solar system. You know, in the solar system, various planets are revolving around the sun. Similarly, in an atom, the electrons are revolving around the nucleus. So here there is a resemblance between the atom and the solar system. In the solar system, planets are revolving around the sun. So this is the similarity between the atom and the solar system. Further, next feature of Rutherford's atomic model the protons in the nucleus are equal to the number of extranuclear electrons. Means the electrons which are present around the nucleus, number of electrons and number of protons are equal. Hence total positive charge on nucleus is equal to the total negative charge on all electrons. Here the total positive charge on the nucleus, the positive charge is due to the presence of protons inside the nucleus. So that total positive charge on the nucleus is equal to the total negative charge carried by all electrons. Hence the atom is electrically neutral. Atom is here electrically neutral. Total charge of the atom is zero because the number of protons inside the nucleus are equal to the number of electrons which are revolving around the nucleus. And you know that the proton and electron carry charge which is equal in magnitude but opposite in sign. Proton are positively charged, electrons are negatively charged. But the magnitude of charge on both the types of particles is equal. And therefore, here the total positive charge on the nucleus become equal to the total negative charge on the electrons. And therefore, the atom become electrically neutral. And the next feature of the Rutherford's atomic model is the electrons are held with the nucleus. Electrons are held with the nucleus by electrostatic force of attraction. Electrostatic force of attraction. In between the nucleus and electrons, there is the electrostatic force of attraction. These electrons around the nucleus are held with the nucleus by means of electrostatic force of attraction. So these are the various features of the Rutherford's atomic model. Such type of model for an atom was suggested by Rutherford. But this model of Rutherford has some drawbacks. So here we are going to study the drawbacks of Rutherford's atomic model. Drawbacks. The model which was suggested by Rutherford for an atom has some drawbacks. Number one, according to Rutherford, electrons are revolving around the nucleus. Electrons are revolving around the nucleus. Now, electron is a charged particle. Electron carry charge. It is a negatively charged particle. Now, according to the Maxwell electromagnetic theory, electromagnetic theory which was given by Maxwell. According to that Maxwell electromagnetic theory, when any charged particle accelerates, means when there is a movement of any charged particle, when any charged particle moves, when there is a displacement of the charged particle or movement of the charged particle, then definitely that charged particle losses energy. It gives up energy. It emits energy. It losses energy. This was the Maxwell's electromagnetic theory. So according to this electromagnetic theory which was suggested by Maxwell, any charged particle, that is a particle having a charge, when accelerates means when it moves, then that charged particle releases energy, gives up energy, losses energy. And therefore, according to this Maxwell theory, in an atom, the electrons are revolving around the nucleus. Electrons are in motion. They get accelerated. There is the acceleration of electrons. Means electrons are moving around the nucleus. And electron is a charged particle. And therefore, according to Maxwell theory, this electron will continuously lose energy because it is a charged particle and its movement occurs around the nucleus. The electrons are revolving around the nucleus. And therefore, during their movement around the nucleus, the electron will lose energy. The electron will give up energy. Electron will release energy. And therefore, the electron will come closer and closer to the nucleus. After the release of energy, after the loss of energy, the distance between that electron and the nucleus will decrease. When the electron will further loss energy, again the distance will decrease. When the electron will further loss energy, again the distance between the electron and the nucleus will decrease. And in this way, during the movement of electron around the nucleus, that electron will follow a spiral path. Spiral. You must do spiral. That electron will follow the spiral path. See here. This is the nucleus and the center of the atom, and this is the electron. So this electron, when moves around the nucleus, it will lose energy, and therefore it will come closer and closer to the nucleus. The distance between the electron and the nucleus will decrease. This electron will follow a spiral path. Spiral. This is the electron. This electron is moving around the nucleus. This is the nucleus. During its movement, it will lose energy according to the Maxwell theory. Its energy will not remain constant. It will continuously lose energy. And because of loss in energy, the distance between the electron and the nucleus will decrease. And therefore, that electron will follow the spiral pathway. Spiral. And finally, that electron will fall into the nucleus. Finally, the electron will fall into the nucleus. Here, this electron finally drops into the nucleus. It falls into the nucleus. It merges into the nucleus. That electron merges into the nucleus. It falls into the nucleus. Because it continuously loses energy. Due to the loss of energy, the distance between the electron and the nucleus continuously decreases. And therefore, that electron will follow the spiral pathway. And finally, it will drop or fall into the nucleus. The time required for the fall of electron into the nucleus is very small. The time required is about 10 raised to power minus 10 seconds. In this very small time, the electron will fall into the nucleus. And therefore, this atom, this model of an atom, Rutherford's model of an atom, will be unstable. The structure of atom which is suggested by Rutherford will not be stable. Now here you should know the meaning of stability. Stable means what? Anything is said to be stable whenever it can exist for long time. Anything which is in existence for long period, it's said to be stable. And anything which cannot exist for long time, that is said to be unstable. The model or structure of atom which is suggested by Rutherford will not be stable. Means it cannot exist for long time. It will be unstable. It cannot exist. This is the drawback of the Rutherford's atomic model. The model which is suggested by Rutherford has drawback that this model will not be stable. The structure of atom which is suggested by Rutherford is not stable. It cannot be in existence for long time. But fact is different. Reality or the truth is different. Actually, the atom is quite stable. The atoms of most of the elements are quite stable. This is the truth or the fact. But this fact or the truth cannot be explained by the Rutherford's atomic model. Rutherford's model of an atom cannot explain the stability of the atom. According to the Rutherford's atomic model, the atom will be unstable. The structure of the atom suggested by the Rutherford will be unstable. It cannot exist. This is the drawback of the Rutherford's atomic model. The second most important drawback of the Rutherford's atomic model is that Rutherford doesn't explain the distribution of electrons in the atom. Rutherford doesn't explain the distribution of electrons in an atom. You know, this is the outermost orbit. This is the size of the atom and this is the size of the nucleus. According to Rutherford's atomic model, an electron can have any position. The electron can have any position from the wall of the nucleus to the size of the atom. The electron may be present at any position. There is no any fixed position for the electron. According to Rutherford. According to Rutherford, the electron may exist at any position from the wall of the nucleus to the outermost orbit. In between the wall of the nucleus and the outermost orbit, the electron may have any position. Means the distribution of electron in the atom is not explained by Rutherford. Distribution of electron in the atom is not explained by Rutherford's atomic model. Actually, this